Joining me now is entrepreneur Pete Snyder. He is recently announced that he is running for governor in Virginia. Pete, thank you so much for coming on.
Katie and Daily Caller, great to be with you. Thanks for having me.
So if you look at the past decade, Virginia has been pretty blue. Why do you think that, you know, Virginia has gone so blue for the past few years? And do you think you have a shot at running for governor as a Republican?
I absolutely think I have a shot. I wouldn't be running if I didn't think so. I'm an entrepreneur at heart. So, hey, having tough odds or maybe everything not stacked my way doesn't daunt me one bit. You can't start a small business or take an idea and turn it into reality in America if you don't have the gumption to go out there and hustle. And unfortunately, Virginia has been trending in the wrong direction. And it shows. You know, the policies brought together by the Northam McAuliffe administration, 8 years of it so far, we have our schools that are closed. We're a year into this pandemic. Our schools are still closed when Joe Biden's own coronavirus task force and the CDC says that they should be open. Our kids are wasting away. Our parents are put in impossible situations. And small businesses, because of the governor's ridiculous and ham-handed mandates, are crushing the hearts and souls of our economy, which is small business.
When you talk about this COVID crisis, I know you set up the Virginia 30-Day Fund, and you also have been very involved with Barstool Sports. Why are you so passionate about helping out these small businesses that really need help right now?
This past year, right when the pandemic broke out, my wife and I saw what was happening to small businesses, and we decided to step in and help. I've been a small business owner all my life. My wife worked on Capitol Hill for 15 years. She took one look at the CARES Act, $2 trillion being pumped into our economy. Sometimes Washington has good intentions, sometimes bad. In this case, let's call it good intentions. But she said that money will never hit the bank accounts of the people who need it the most in time. Most small businesses only have 2 weeks of cash reserve on hand. And no way in heck were the SBA and PPP loans going to hit them. So we stepped in, gathered friends and neighbors, started the Virginia 30-Day Fund, and have been able to help businesses all across Virginia. 10 months later, we funded over 850 just in Virginia alone, and we'll be helping 1,100 folks in the coming weeks. But then we had our friend Sarah Sanders call up from Arkansas and said, I love what you're doing. Can I do it in Arkansas? So Sarah started the Arkansas 30-Day Fund. And Pennsylvania and New Jersey and Georgia followed, Mississippi as well. Then we got a phone call in December from the CEO of Barstool Sports, who said, hey, Dave Portnoy's out there. He cares about small businesses. No one has been advocating on behalf of the plight of small businesses the way Dave Portnoy has this year. And we partnered up with Barstool Fund. So their fund runs through the Virginia 30-Day Fund. They're a sister fund of ours. And we've been helping folks all across America, have raised $40 million in the past few weeks, every single dime of it going to help and going into the pockets of small business owners.
That's incredible. And you know, it doesn't seem like the media is focusing on these small businesses that need help right now. Why do you think that is? I mean, the Daily Caller has been covering it extensively, but.
Katie, you all have done an amazing job. I mean, Martin's Tavern was saved based on your reporting and the Daily Caller putting a spotlight out there on what these people are going through. You know, only 10% of the companies that Virginia 30-Day funded have accepted or been given SBA or PPP loans. These are the people that are caught between the couch cushions. And as one entrepreneur told me, Pete, we feel unseen and unheard, and no one's advocating on our behalf. Thank you for all that you're doing. So we need to work together. Yeah, the liberal media is going to focus on what the liberal media does. We need to focus on the hardworking heroes that are actually the backbone of this country. That's what we're doing with Virginia 30-Day, the Barstool Fund, and that's what I'm going to do as the next governor of Virginia.
You know, some people will criticize you for your lack of experience in politics. I know you ran for office back in 2013, but do you think it helps you or hurts you? I mean, you look at Donald Trump, who has had all this success, and he didn't really have a background in politics.
Sure. Look, I wear the fact that I'm not a career politician
and I've never held elective office as a badge of honor. You know, if you want to see how I'll do things, just take one look about what we did in Virginia over the past year and what we're continuing to do with Virginia 30 Day Fund. Yeah, I didn't go out there and ask people who needed help, whether they're Republican or Democrat, or people who were helping us. We were just Virginians rolling up our sleeves, trying to perform triage to save as many small businesses as we could. We didn't ask about ideology or how they view the president or any of that garbage. It doesn't matter. We rolled up our sleeves and got the job done. That's what I'll do as the next governor of Virginia.
I do want to ask you about something Governor Northam is pushing forward right now. He is very passionate about having free community college. What are your thoughts on this, especially considering people that have already paid for college would be paying for this, and people that didn't even go to college, like plumbers and taxi cab drivers? What do you think about that?
Why are we talking about free anything as it relates to schools when our schools are closed?
Yeah.
I mean, this is absurd. Let the main thing be the main thing. We're a year into this pandemic. Our schools are still closed. Our small businesses are dying. People who desperately want a vaccine can't get it because of Ralph Northam and his lack of planning and his lack of leadership. I mean, he can focus on all the freebies that he wants, but people are dying. Our economy needs to be turned around, and we need to allow teachers to do the job they love back in the classroom, teaching our students before they fall further behind. All of this is typical Richmond garbage, and we need to get rid of all of it.
My last question to you would be, you know, the effects of COVID are still lingering, and it's, of course, going to impact your race. How do you plan on, you know, campaigning during this time? Are you going to do in-person events? Are you going to knock on doors? Or are you going to do things more virtually?
Sure. All of the above. We are going to be as aggressive and safe as possible. So we're going to go to every single corner of this Commonwealth on foot, by car, by plane, whatever it may be, by Zoom. There is not a single county or locality that we're not going to go out there and try to create the broadest coalition of Republicans and talk to millions of independents and lean Democrats who are sick and tired of the way the Commonwealth is going, the fact that their kids are locked out of the classroom and small businesses are dying, and they're going to help vote me in as your next governor of Virginia. We do that, we win, we're going to fix Virginia, and Virginia's going to lead again.
Well, Pete, we will be following your race very closely. Thank you for coming on today.
Hey, thank you so much, and I can't wait to get you out there putting a spotlight on some of the amazing businesses in Virginia, and let's get them some help.